I'm just gonna play some guitar and watch some news.
Standing by in the heat for us, and they call us in Moscow. Nick, let me start with you this hour. we are seeing clearly as we've just outlined a big push for diplomacy and really for de-escalation. But is there anything concrete in it that the UN can do to compel Russia to stand down in Ukraine?
Well, it puts Russia under greater pressure. It messages Russia that this is not just the United States saying this. This is many countries who will be around the table at the UN Security Council. Russia has denied so many times that it has no intention of invading Ukraine. And the U.S. negotiating position or discussion position with them has been, if you are serious about following the diplomatic track, then there is no need to have this military going there. But Russia insists the troops are on sovereign territory, all sharing, sharing territory with Belarus, So Russia's position, it has a legitimate right to be there and be training its troops. So perhaps that's what we can understand between the lines, perhaps from the U.S. representative, the ambassador of the United Nations, when she said, we're going to go in the room ready to listen, but we're going to be prepared to challenge them on their propaganda. And I think that will probably try to get to some of the specificity of what the U.S. believes and sees that is happening there on the ground. But the pressure to turn Russia around on its position, this demand that they de-escalate and move troops back to base has been going on for some time, and Russia has so far resisted and still appears to be on track to continue with its military exercises.
Let's stay with us. Let me go to Melissa and Kiev. And Melissa, we have seen a flurry of meetings in the last several weeks, but as we prepare for this UN meeting, what is the mood as well as
I don't see how they're going to resolve this if Russia's truly there to keep Ukraine out of NATO
that, as people just say,
and deal with the West, because Ukraine says they're not going to be in NATO and deal with the West.
To question of what the others believe or are saying or their intentions, but of course, with the need for a veto, even for a statement, nothing concrete
this is
will come out of it beyond the discussion itself.
This will give a
that
list of demands.
All of them should be
They've been pretty vague on what Russia's list of demands is.
The German and French as well. And I think what,
just as vague as they've been about Joe Rogan's sins, about Joe Rogan's alleged misinformation. They keep saying it exists, but none of them tell us what it is.
Speaking to CNN yesterday on that package of sanctions being prepared, and that they expect will go through the Senate bipartisan package.
And sometimes when misinformation turns into actual information. It happened to me. I tweeted something about a lab on Facebook. I sent out a message about a lab leak, and they cited it, and they suspended it. They gave me a warning or some kind of slap on the wrist, froze the account for a little while. And it was before the lab leak was an accepted theory or possibility or probability or whatever. And I couldn't believe they did that. So yeah, sometimes things that are just out on approved theories or mainstream theories turn out to be true. The word phrase conspiracy theory used to have a more positive connotation than I've heard.
Tough words, and also the possibility of diplomacy is one that goes about its business very much as usual with Ukrainians out on the streets, nothing but particular tensions we noted here, but everyone really conscious of the fact that this is a war that has dragged on here in Ukraine for much of the last 8 years, and everyone keeping a wary eye on what is happening across the border, but with a sort of sense of much greater calm, I think, than you'd expect, given all that rhetoric we've heard around Ukraine over the last few weeks. I think we're likely to see the U.S. Security Council raise its voice. And I know you're both keeping a close eye on the health of the people who are visiting today. Liz Belfaron, there in Kiev, and the President in Moscow, thank you very much. And in about 20 minutes or so, we'll show you why Russia is turning to Western media. They promise to return to the political of calling them propagandists. Now, North Korea is confirming what happened to the country's state-run news agency, Pyongyang, test-firing an intermediate range missile known as the Hwasong-12 on Sunday. Now, this was the most powerful ballistic missile North Korea has tested since 2017, and the seventh missile test this month alone. The Biden administration says it would like to return to the diplomatic talks with Pyongyang. It's a bit more of a cyber-lucky, not really all for us.
looks like they know how to deal with North Korea is Dennis Rodman. Which party is Dennis Rodman in?
But there has been no response from North Korea back to the
US. It doesn't seem to matter who's in office. Banging the same drum.
Very different kinds of messages with this just flurry of missile second round in just 1 month. Much more missile activity than we've seen in years, really since 2017, when North Korea was making its displeasure known to the world and to the U.S. That was during the Trump administration, and there was very public diplomacy insults being rolled back and forth between Pyongyang and Washington, sometimes on Twitter, and then subsequently the historically made diplomacy between then President Trump and Kim Jong-un. The White House position has been willing to talk to the North Koreans, but not at the level of heads of state. And again, there has not been said to be have flown about 800 kilometers distance wide at a height of 2,000 kilometers. It's been condemned by the South Koreans. South Korean defense minister meeting with troops that are in charge of air defense for South Korea, by the Japanese, by the U.S. as well, saying it's in violation of the United Nations Security Council resolutions. South Korea's position here is very interesting, not only because he's the immediate neighbor, but also because the president, Moon Jae-in, is a lame duck. There will be elections in March. He staked most of his term on trying to build bridges with North Korea on face-to-face diplomacy, and he predicted on Sunday after his latest missile launch that it's possible North Korea could end its moratorium and could start intercontinental ballistic missile launches and nuclear tests, which I think everybody would agree would set back relations and heighten tensions dramatically on the Korean Peninsula.
I've been very, very quickly. Do you know is there an interpretation as to why we've seen such a flurry of activity in this past month or so?
Quickly, North Korea is having a tough time economically. Publicly acknowledged problems with food supplies for its population, but more than a year ago, its leader put out a guideline for military things he wanted to accomplish, and some of the launches that we've seen recently are ticking off those guidelines. And another goal that he had set for his own military was an intercontinental ballistic missile launch, so analysts are predicting that could be coming.
Yeah, unfortunately, it's becoming a more of a regular thing than what we've been seeing here. Hopefully, it's not sudden, trying to normalize this activity, and that is all the good stuff. Ivan Watson, first in Hong Kong, thanks very much, Ivan. Former U.S. President Donald Trump won't let go of the fourth narrative.
I didn't hear them mention Guam. But I read that they say they can reach Guam with a missile now.
Working to reform the Electoral Count Act, believes Mike Pence has the right to change the outcome. And this is where you're going. Let me read it out to you. Actually, what they are saying is that Mike Pence did have the right to change the outcome, and they now want to take that right away. Unfortunately, if they didn't exercise the power, he could have overturned the election. That's the member of representative lawyer.
Man, I wish they would give every ex-president equal time. Imagine that. If we had to hear about Bush, Obama, Trump, if it all had to been equal, wouldn't that be journalistic? Why does Donald Trump dominate every ex-president?
The vice president gets to choose the next president, in which case Kamala Harris will be presiding at the counting of the votes. And I guess he's saying she gets to choose who the next president is. That's clear what the Constitution
sprinkling some Jefferson quotes.
He must be kidding.
Stuff like that.
Meanwhile, at a weekend rally, Trump said he was urging more protests if prosecutors take action.
If these radical fascists, racist prosecutors do anything wrong with it, I hope we are going to have in this
corrupt.
At the same time,
if I run, do I win?
It's like South America.
We will treat those people from January 6th fairly. We will treat them fairly. And if it requires pardons, we will give them pardons. Because they are being treated so unfairly.
But there is bipartisan rejection of Trump's comments about pardoning the riots.
I think it's inappropriate. I don't want to reinforce that the mountain gap here is okay. I don't want to do anything that would make this more likely in the future. And I want to deter people who did what the, on January the 6th and those who...
Yep, that's when he split. Like, it's been blah, 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 but this is where I draw the line. And they send rioters into Congress to like hang Mike Pence and shit on desks. He's like, that's it. That's it. That's when he cut wave. That was a bridge too far for Lindsey Graham.
I'll take care of you. I'll give you a pardon. Now, that's something nobody, Republican or Democrat, should accept. But that is the third world voting.
And of course, there'll be much more on this story right in here. Now, a search is underway in Germany for at least one suspect after two police officers were fatally shot during a traffic stop. Police say the 24-year-old policewoman and 29-year-old policeman were shot after calling for backup. Investigators are at the crime scene and have expanded the search to the neighboring state. The force says we get more details on the story and development story we shall bring them. In the meantime, the Beijing Winter Olympics kick off this week, but as final preparations are being made, new infections are on the rise. We'll go live to Beijing for the latest. Plus, the northeaster duck bat at the U.S. East Coast has moved on, but the meteorologist technical area has another winter storm still away.
Historic storm finally over across the northeast.
Drug commercial. And another commercial. Yeah, I can't think of other options on that whole build-up. I should probably figure out what they want and get it over. Strings stayed in tune, so it's the sound of a good guitar. I think it was weather related, why the two of them were just totally out. Should probably check it in the lines. Sounds pretty good. As long as they tune it up every time before I play it, it's better. Thank you. portion is wholly uninspiring. I hate Russian portion. Yikes. Noise to leave behind record snowfall, freezing temps.
Tens of thousands have lost power due to strong winds from the bomb cyclone, but almost all servers have now been restored. The storm has left behind very chilling, as you can see temperatures to record snowfall in some areas. This view from space shows extensive snow from North Carolina up to Maine. Their dangerous conditions have also made travel a mess, you can imagine, with about 5,000 flights canceled this weekend alone. The big cold stretch all the way down to Florida.
Whoa, that's a frozen lizard.
And it's so cold there. That's why you're seeing iguanas on the screen, because they're going into shock.
Hollandale Beach.
That's how cold it is.
Dude, that lizard looks fake. Stunned.
You should have got four of them rolling there. Now,
wow.
Over the worst
this thing's falling trees in Florida.
You know, for the Northeast, we are for at least a few days, he said, but it looks like changes are definitely going to be back into the forecast later.
I think the reason why is because they're not from that part of the world. And they've been taken there, and so they're not used to that temperature dropping to that part of that cold. But there's no predators right there right now to kill them off, so they just do that. I didn't see any of these in Miami. All I saw was tiny lizards. So I think those bigger ones like that are north more. I'd like to say they're not in my area, but they're not in my area. Degrees in Miami. 47 in Pensacola.
Watching that. And in the NFC, the Rams beat the San Francisco 49ers 20-17. This exceptional late in the game. final closing ages as Spanish superstar Rafael Nadal rallied back from two sets down to win the men's singles title. The win puts Nadal's name in the record with his 23rd Grand Slam title, the most ever by a men's tournament. The 35-year-old beat Russia's 30th Wednesday in 5 sets and got Lava Arena on
inside the supposed move accounts for a tiny percentage of all the games participants in the bubbles, and the state media also saying so far there's no community spread of the virus within the bubbles, and that's why they're not portraying this as in a way of testament how well their system has been working, and they intend to keep it that way. But obviously this is an increasingly daunting task as time goes by and with more events kicking off, especially given how contagious the Omicron variant is. But most of our senior colleagues covering these games have now arrived, and one of their first impressions was the high walls and the fences around their hotel and all the other venues. And I think in a way that's almost a metaphor of this sense of disconnect between a lot of, if not most, urban Chinese citizens and the Olympics games this time. As you know, there's not a single ticket available for sale to the general public because of the pandemic. A lot of people have also seen their travel plans ruined or disrupted because of the increasingly tightened travel regulations and our Beijing business is right now at Lunar New Year, the most important Chinese holiday. Other than that, a lot of people are unfortunately stuck where they are because they don't know what's in their loved ones, and that means when on social media and the people on the ground. We feel this sense of frustration and loneliness and sometimes even
new mutation.
If you had Omicron infection, you should have protection against subsequent infection from this new variant. That's why I don't think this is going to create a huge wave of infection. What's likely to happen is, as we were coming down, we're coming down quite sharply in parts of the Northeast, Florida, the Mid-Atlantic, you might see as this new strain starts to pick up, you might see that we start to slow down in that decline, but the decline will happen nonetheless.
Meantime, the latest data from the U.S. CDC shows only about 41% of Americans received a booster shot. And this comes as science...
New version of Omicron, not a cause for alarm. I haven't checked the death toll in a few days. Yeah, what do you know?
Doesn't mean that we have to stop everything that we're doing now. The good thing about this variant is that it looks like there is no immune escape, meaning that all those individuals who are vaccinated and boosted are still well protected. And also that there have been many, many people in the U.S. and around the world who've been infected with Omicron. Those individuals are very unlikely to be reinfected with this new variant. And so I think that should give us a sigh of relief, even as we are still being vigilant and making sure that we're preparing for the worst.
Amid rising tensions with Ukraine, Russia state media stepping up its propaganda push, and one Western host is getting a lot of airtime. Have the details for you after the break. And then later,
Russia because of its corrupted Eastern European
is not in the direction that they need.
Propaganda war truth doesn't matter. What counts is stopping a war they are convinced America is fermenting.
So at this point, NATO exists primarily to torment Vladimir Putin.
At home, facing accusations of being a pro-Putin stooge, Carlson has defended some of his pro-Russian comments and said he is not a Russian agent. So the news is also rebellion. It's not the way any respectable journalist would want to be portrayed. But once inside the current spin cycle here, there's no knowing that the machine will spit you out. Nick Robertson, CNN, Moscow.
Is there from Nick Robertson. Well, one U.S. national security expert says Russia's disinformation campaigns go hand in hand with Ukraine's.
I think the Republicans have more ties with Russia and Democrats don't. And that's part of what's going on. But a lot of the government does not have ties with Russia. They're not proud of them in Missouri. They keep it quiet. Them and China both. They kind of villainize those two and use them as scapegoats in the beginning.
Our democracy. And we know that they're capable of far more, including ransomware attacks and attacks that can destroy our economy. What we haven't yet seen is actual physical damage. I hope we don't see that, but they certainly have the capability of doing that, as they've shown elsewhere.
And of course, we'll have much more on the story, including the latest developments on today's main national report. I want to take you from the Middle East, where the United Arab Emirates has destroyed a routine ballistic missile launch site in Yemen. The UAE released this video, which they claim shows the damage. They say the launch site was destroyed after their forces intercepted and destroyed another ballistic missile targeting the UAE. The Houthis have since claimed responsibility for the attack. And this comes after a series of attacks initiated by the Iran-backed Houthis against the UAE.
Leslie Graham, a senator from North Carolina. This Supreme Court pick is from his state, South Carolina. So let's see if they make that real clear. But is there some time? That's interesting that the Western media is reporting on how the Russian media is saying that the Western media is trying to start a war. Although they're not really including Fox News. And they say Tucker Carlson is popular there. That's what the graphic on CNN just said. And Tucker Carlson is an anchor on Fox News. So, yeah. Well, I think Russians... It's a huge country, and the people are real diverse. From east to west. It's in Asia, and it's in Europe. But I think, though, some of the people are more conservative. I think there's probably more conservative. Maybe there's more conservative people there than liberal people. And they identify with the Republican Party more. I've heard some of the social issues that they seem to be for and against, and they do sound pretty conservative. The other thing is energy, too. I think the Democrats have a clean energy future here and a new vision, and I think the Republicans and the Russians have a dirty energy agenda.
Thank you.
Russia and China didn't even go to that meeting, whatever it was called, the environmental meeting earlier last year, the one that Joe Biden fell asleep in. Greta Thunberg said it was just a big joke. Yeah, well, they didn't even bother going. Okay, there it is in Little Running. U.S. Senate Republican on CNN, and they're quoting Face the Nation. This is our South Carolina.
She's one of the most decent people I've ever met. It would be good for the court to have somebody who's not at Harvard.
He's a pretty straight shooter, and so. He's in the opposite party, so. He is also from South Carolina. He has made it very clear to Biden. It's hard to believe that there hasn't been a black female justice yet.
He is backing, he is rooting for, he makes appeals to a diverse within this diverse group, that she is from the South, that she doesn't have an Ivy League background. But we don't want to get into ourselves here. Police say the 50-year-old jumped from a New York high-rise on Sunday. And this was an attorney who sought to help reform America's justice system. She won the Miss USA crown in 2019. In a statement, her family says she inspired others around the world with her beauty as well as her strength. If you or someone in your force is struggling with suicide, of course, the National Suicide Prevention Lifeline can help.
That's it. Well, I used to answer a suicide hotline calls.
30-year-old who died from a suspected overdose early this month.
The fatal exposure is thought to have occurred at a school in Hot Texas, Texas, as the band of highly addicted opioids were moved from the school. We'd say this earlier in the fentanyl found in this contract was the same substance that caused his opioids. They're still investigating how he got the drug. And still to come right on the show, what Spotify is doing to prevent COVID-19 misinformation after several artists exited the platform over the Joe Rogan case.
One role of a lifetime, once.
It's funny how Spotify, all I've heard is that they've lost 5 musicians that are like probably over 70 years old. Isn't that strange? Out of everybody on Spotify, those are the only people they've lost, I think. I can't name them all off the top of my head, but there was like Joni Mitchell, and she was probably like when my mom was a kid, I think. And then Neil Young and Barry Manilow, I think. I'll have to double check with Barry Manilow because I have, well, I think, one of his songs. And who else? Can't remember who else. Like one or two other like very old bands. So weird. It's weird that it's from their generation, because I see those, or I saw those people as like from a generation that wanted to be heard, you know. And then I think theirs was the Vietnam War issues were the major ones that made them famous and gave them a name. And I'm playing at Woodstock. My mom went to Woodstock in 1969. And so she told me about it, and I went to the one in 1994. And so, it used to be a lot different, and they were, like, fighting for rights, and they didn't want people to have to die in war and be drafted over there and fight in a stupid war. And then there's, like, a free love movement, and a women's liberation movement, and, like, rights movement, voting, and all that stuff. There's just all kinds of issues, and everybody wanted to be heard. And now they're, like, stifling free speech, and they're saying, no, this guy shouldn't be heard. Or if he's heard, then I'm out of here. In a sense, it's not a big deal. He's just stating how he feels and doing what he wants to do. But then, because he said that and did it, then it invokes a peer pressure, a chain reaction of like the cancel culture mob, like taking sides and kind of going crazy. So Spotify's solution was to just put a little notice on there about COVID if somebody's like him is talking about COVID. I think one of the other companies did that too. I think Twitter does that and Facebook does that. So if somebody just sends a message and has the word COVID in it, it'll just attach like a little link on there basically saying if you want some solid information on this virus that's proven medical information from scientists or whatever, click this link and read about it, the facts. You know, it's their platform, it's their rules. They're just trying to cover their ass so they don't get sued. So that's the price to pay if you want to use it. You gotta pay with their advertisements or whatever. That's why I like to put my blog on my website. I don't use Tumblr anymore. I stopped using them years ago. I tried the WordPress and one other one, Blogspot. They're okay. I don't know, but I prefer just coding it and posting it myself. Protests against COVID-19 mandates continue in Ottawa.
I
want to go to Ottawa.
I've
never said that before.
Started out as a truckers protest, right? It was called the Freedom Convoy, and they started from all parts around Canada. They wanted to gather here, travel to Ottawa, to protests a vaccine mandate that was put in not just by Canada, but by the Biden administration. That went into effect earlier this month. But this has turned into so much more. It's really touched a nerve with a significant minority in Canada who say enough is enough. They're against vaccine mandates, against mask mandates, they're against public health measures. And so they grouped here in Ottawa, and the question now is, when are they going to...
Pretty interesting, right? Because BC Canadians is generally pretty liberal.
There are still wall-to-wall...
And these people are kind of siding with the conservatives, at least in the United States. I suspect these people are more libertarian, more just want people just hands-off, not necessarily other conservatives.
No sign of that. Prime Minister Justin Trudeau remains at an undisclosed location.
Kind of sort of a melting pot, too, because people come to that country from the U.S. and a lot of other countries.
Having said that as well, Ottawa police continue to investigate some incidents. One that was especially serious where people, really showing disrespect.
What kind of people are protesting there? This is a little contrary to the
right now, Ottawa
Canadian mainstream.
The priority is to get everyone out of the city safely. Protesters, though,
Toronto, you haven't seen a big outrage. They've been pretty much falling in line, or they haven't been showing it to us.
Thanks very much for the news from that. Now, Spotify says it will now add a content advisory.
And the major cities are obviously like riots and revolting in Canada. And I've heard they've been pretty strict.
Spotify CEO Daniel Ek wrote a public letter on the platform's website on Sunday explaining Spotify's rules and how he says he'll do more to combat COVID-19 misinformation. Ek says, quote, "It's important to me that we don't take on the position of being content censor. We're also making sure that there are rules in place that cause voices within the violate them." He says Spotify is working to add a content advisory to any podcast episode that includes discussion about COVID-19. It will direct listeners to a COVID-19 hub that provides data driven facts and up-to-date information from trusted sources in the public health community. In an effort to be more transparent, Spotify also published its long-standing platform rules. The partner rules addressing false or deceptive medical information says content cannot cause offline harm or pose a direct threat to public health. Some examples Spotify gave include saying that COVID-19 is a hoax or suggesting that vaccines are designed to kill people. Notably, the controversial podcast by Joe Rogan that was spread misinformation is still available exclusively on the streaming platform. His podcast is the one cited by 250 doctors, nurses, and scientists in an open letter to Spotify earlier this month, calling for a stronger enforcement policy on misinformation. Then, within the last week, Neil Young, Joni Mitchell, Mill Loughran all said they would remove their music from Spotify. Renee Brown said she would pause on releasing new episodes of her podcast. And Prince Harry and Meghan...
And this guy, what a dope.
...with Spotify to produce and host
this guy from the UK.
...released a statement through their foundation spokesperson that said they urged Spotify to meet the moment.
Spotify
about this issue as early as April of last year. Spotify shares are down 7.7%.
I agree. They should tell him to be quiet.
Thanks very much, Natasha Chen, for this fantastic call. Now, if Elon Musk offered you $5,000...
I don't get it. Why he's charming and why he has that perspective. It's pretty weird. Sometimes these filthy rich people are in just such a bubble, they only come out of it once in a while to take sides to a cause. And it's like, whoa, what the hell? Where have you been? Why are you saying this now about this? Jesus Christ. So yeah, so this guy from this other country wants them to be anti-free speech in the United States. That's right. Thanks.
Despite
the warnings of a historic
surrounded by family, as well as friends. This is crazy. tells the meeting on Ukraine tensions continue. Formerly Salman Exegol from Borough Jerich, you know how to reach out to me. Thanks so much for watching. I shall see you tomorrow.
On FanDuel Sportsbook, new customers can bet 30-1 odds on any team in the playoffs.